So, Sal, what are your next big areas for growth? Where do you see them?
Yeah, you know, I think the exciting thing for us, and I have to, you know, we're now a team approaching 40 folks. The big focus actually is not on the videos. I mean, the videos, I mean, to Clay's point, kind of got us that traction that we can now start to improve and do the things that people, frankly, have been talking about for a long time. And so even from day one when we got our first significant support, most of our investment has been on the interactive side, the exercises, the dashboards, the feedback, the analytics. And what we're hoping to do in the next year is get to the point that Khan Academy can give you diagnostics and assessments and knowledge state and measure your knowledge state better than any assessments on the planet. And if we can do that, there's several areas where it could be very powerful. One, for the first time, we can actually, in real time at internet speed, do control studies of, okay, it feels like Sal's tutorials are good, but maybe for a certain class of student, Mary's tutorials are better. And we can actually measure that. It won't just even be subjective measure. We'll actually see how the learning state changes. We think it's crazy that every teacher on the planet is writing and grading their own assessments without having any benchmarks, without having all of these inputs that we have. We have 3 million exercises done every day by 6 million students a month. And so we can start to do analytics not just on did they get it right or wrong, which choices did they pick, what was their activity before or after, how long did it take, which we're finding is a huge correlant. We can start to do things that the traditional system has never done, to Clay's point, which is retention, context switching. I mean, I've always said the best education would be, okay, you pass the algebra exam in ninth grade, but then while you're walking in the halls in 10th grade, your ninth grade algebra teacher pops up and says, okay, I have a pop quiz for you just to make sure you still remembered what you learned last year. And we all know most of us don't remember most of it. And we're already seeing it in the data. You're seeing the forgetting curve, and we're starting to do spaced repetition, context switching, all of these things. So it's starting to become very analytical about improving the process. So that, the assessments, the diagnostics, the analytics, and internationalization is also a big push, so that there will be essentially Khan Academy in every major language in the next year.
Can I say that this is so stunning? So if you look at the analogy that I stated early, then look at the time period for the electronically distributed entertainment to become of the same quality of reproduction, even, you know, it started crappy. What's your more better phrase? If you look at the old Victrolas, early radio, early black and white TV, fuzzy, it was just good enough. No one would say it was possibly as good as being there live. Now with high definition TV and all that, it's a pretty good replica. But that took 70, 80 years. Now look at what Saul's doing. In 4 years since starting this in earnest, he's gone from the earliest stages to now where the assessments are better, the testing is better, the education, the actual videos are better than most teachers teach the same subject. It's now moved in 4 years from not just good enough, but to be better. The ability to stop, the ability to look and listen to it again, which doesn't happen in a classroom. The ability for the teacher to have a dashboard of the progress of every student and live be able to see how each student is performing and help those. All of this has gone from zero to better in just 4 years.
Some credit here, Scott and Signe have been a part of this, just so that there's some vested interest. I don't know, that's why.
We're just fans.
Yes.